This story, although set in the past, is about the future. Where I know freedom is. In the smallest of things, I see the flicker of hope.
Samuel. Go, boy. Go.
No one can shackle the hope that is hidden in our hearts. If only you will believe it, Samuel.
You're late.
I got held up. Had to break up a fight in one of the cabins.
Didn't hold Jerome long enough at Cabin 15. You go ahead. Meet you at the bridge. I'll fetch them dogs away.
Sure, Samuel.
Thank the Lord.
Where's Big Hand?
He'll be by soon, son.
Even as we make our way toward freedom, would it ever be possible to leave behind what we'd endured?
Lord have mercy.
He hadn't talked?
He is nearly unconscious.
Where are the others?
The others have vanished, Mr. Monroe.
Praise God Almighty.
Where are they?
If they get away because of your stupidity. Now you leave him strung up, yeah? And get a hold of Plimpton.
Plimpton?
I want my property back before nightfall.
All of you, back to work.
Come on now.
To carry me
home. Samuel? Samuel Woodward?
Yes.
Thomas Garrett.
Mr. Garrett?
You must be Vanessa. Adira? Ma'am? And this is Jim. Hello, son. You've done well. Big Hand? I see. Come on.
We began our long journey north with Mr. Garrett on pathways known only to the Underground Railroad.
Mr. Garrett! Mom, Grandma!
I'm all right.
Whoa.
In here.
Would have never happened in his old man's day.
I heard tell.
My father was a fool, Plimpton. Took the concept of Christian charity too far. Get out.
Slaves expensive, Plimpton.
And the Underground Railroad, now they are targeting slave owners in Virginia.
I'm retired.
And there's more when they all get recaptured.
All? Well, there's more than one.
There's Samuel, his son, the old woman, and Vanessa. They're gonna be easy to track. No slave has ever escaped from my plantation.
Why don't you send Jerome?
I want him back before they incite the others. Garrett's part of it.
Garrett?
Him and his Quaker cohort, they are a menace to our industry. The entire economy of Virginia is at risk.
Monroe, I am no longer in the slave hunting business.
Now, you made a mistake, Plimpton. Made you weak. Don't let your conscience get in the way of business.
That's $500. I'm gonna give you another 1,000 when you bring them all back. And that's including Vanessa.
Well, you can't let her go, can you? About the old woman.
She's of no use to me. She's too old and too sick.
They're gonna be headed north.
Sending one of my boys with you.
I don't need a babysitter.
He will look after my interests.
They will all be in church on Sunday.
Get yourself a shave. You've done well. Most don't make it this far.
We had help, Mr. Garrett. Jim.
Thank you, Mr. Garrett. Our lives have been... Adira's been a slave all her life. And my son has never seen the sun rise without the threat of a whipping. One day, we pray.
And be the white man's God she prayed to.
Samuel.
Freedom, Samuel. God willing. Freedom.
Why you do this, Miss Garrett?
Sammy, you have to trust.
Like your mama trusted Monroe? He gonna want you back, Nessa. You his blood. Paul used to sing that song.
He loved to sing. You refused to sing. One day you will, son. Amazing grace.
That saved a wretch like me?
I was Jim's age when I first heard it. And the story of the man who wrote it. An infamous slave trader. A wretch like you, Samuel. But he loved to sing.
Kings and queens, or the man in the moon. Broken mirror doesn't mean that someone will die soon. Black cat isn't all bad luck, but redheads won't sink a boat. Life. If you're drowning in the sea, will God keep you afloat?
Congratulations, Captain Newton.
Thank you, Mr. Barton.
Oh, and bravo. I remember a song you wrote about old Captain Penrose. Cruel Newton. but very witty.
But I cannot believe you actually bought shares in the Pegasus, Mr. Barton.
After Penrose died, I acquired his half, and I'm now in partnership with Amos Clow.
Amos Clow?
Clow owns the slave factory on the Plantain Islands, and this will be our first shipment to Charleston. I know you've had your difficulties with Amos, Newton.
He promised me an apprenticeship, Barton. But he treated me like an animal. Like one of his slaves, he actually chained and starved me for 18 months.
It's all in the past. It's all a means to a good end. And now, as we always planned, you have the opportunity to share in the profits, Captain Newton. Now, I have to go to Charleston to set up the slave market. I'll meet you there on your arrival. Time is against us. I need you to leave this week to pick up the first load in Africa.
But Mary...
Your fiancé will want for nothing. That's a lot of money, Newton. Now, the first mate, Davy, will take care of the cargo, and we're giving you one of Amos's slaves. He'll interpret for you. Name's Ozias. My business is now your business. To ambition. Good luck, Newton.
It is blood money.
Mary, I'm simply the captain of Barton's ship. I don't own it, nor the cargo. To me, and I'm sure to your fellow parishioners and most of this nation, it is just business.
You speak of business, and I speak of your soul.
Let's not argue,
a soul,
please.
A soul that I love.
Mary, Mr. Newton.
We'll marry as soon as I return.
I only pray that God allows it.
I'll be away for 6 to 8 months. You know the perils of the sea if I don't return.
John!
If I don't come back, I need to know you'll be cared for.
I don't want you to go. I fear this time I shall never see you again.
Mr. Newton!
I shall pray every day for your return.
Have faith, Mary.
I do. John, I do.
Get back to work.
Slave.
That one there.
One by the table.
Pick him up.
Oh.
done, my boy. Come on.
He set sail that day to a new world. A soul without a compass. Like you, Samuel. Confused, confronted by his past. Desperately hoping to find his freedom and his fortune. On a slave ship. Have faith, Samuel.
Conditions, Plimpton. Always a pleasure.
We got a family of slaves this time, Clem. I sent word on ahead.
Who's this?
This here is my watchdog. I said be ready at sunrise, boy. You ride with me, you follow my orders, you understand?
We won't have a problem, Mr. Plimpton. Who's this?
This is my tracker, Clem.
We bring him back dead or alive.
We bring them all back alive.
That's a damn shame.
Come on, let's get going. Come on, come on.
I got you, Mom.
We're nearly there.
Come on.
There's the cavalry, right on time.
Mr. Garrett.
It's been a long time, sir.
Mr. McGee.
Very good to see you.
Hey,
sir.
Hey, Pete. Be quiet stretch, sir.
There's room for all of us, sir?
Yes, sir, there's room for all of you. Even Mr. Garrett.
Come on.
Ma'am.
You're connect with Phillips on the freight train bound for Philadelphia. Get the family to Woodbridge, and I'll take you there part of the way.
All right, sir.
Hey.
Right up here. It's fine.
It's a couple miles further on. Your fellow escapee, Big Hand?
He was caught. We also heard that Monroe sent Plimpton after you.
How many men he got with him?
He's got two.
That's it? We got more than that.
The railroad doesn't go out of its way to confront these people, Samuel.
Our fate is in God's hands. And we'll protect you with his guidance.
Gentlemen, we got a problem. We got two roads blocked, one just up ahead. Oh, he must want you back real bad.
And we're gonna be exactly what we are. Slaves.
Hush up, my boy.
All right.
Here. Hold up.
What's going on here?
We're looking for runaways.
All we got's these miserable slaves.
This one ain't so miserable.
It's not your property, mister.
Believe me, these ain't runaways. If they were, I'd decorate another tree for you. All right. All right, come on through.
Much obliged.
Father set your tracks, boss.
Garrett's with them, all right.
Hey, a wagon.
How long are you gonna take, Clinton?
We're already a day behind. Monroe will get his slaves back Sunday. Let's move.
Quakers don't believe in guns, Samuel, but I am occasionally grateful that Mr. McGee does.
Should be the last time you have to wear these.
There you are, Jim.
Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Hope can be found in the darkest of places. No one is alone. Believe me, Samuel. There's always hope. Learn from those who have gone before you.
I am a poor pilgrim of sorrow. I'm tossed in this wide world alone. No hope have I for tomorrow. So I've started to make heaven my home. I'm tossed and driven, Lord. Sometimes I don't know where to roam. But I have heard of a city called started making my home. Sometimes I'm tossed and driven, Lord. Sometimes I don't know where to a city called heaven. And I've started to make heaven my home.
I apologize. I didn't mean to startle you.
John Newton.
You must think it strange that I'm in command of a slave ship owned by Amos Clow. You still have your Bible, I see. God has given you very little, his eyes.
Slave has taught me to speak English with this book. But God's words have taught me so much more.
God's words? Surely just written by mere mortal men. It wasn't God who came in the night and gave me food and saved my life.
You were treated so very poorly by Mr. Clow.
I was flogged on board His Majesty's Man of War, his eyes, for desertion. And now I'm in command of a slave ship. I'm the captain of a slave ship. I've learned to expect nothing from God.
I remember one night, the slave factory. Cried out in the dark, "Speak to me, Father. Your servant listens." A huge roar split the heavens. I fell to my knees. I saw the trees bow in his honor. I heard the Lord speak my name in the rustle of the palm leaves. God spoke to me.
Tell me this, then, Ozias. Why does your just and merciful God condemn good people like you and me to slavery?
There are no good people, John Newton. We are all dogs, hunted, shackled, enslaved. That is why we need God.
What's going on?
He was trying to hang himself, Captain. Mofeku. Eric, taking food!
What is he saying? Ozias!
He wants to die.
Tell him we're taking him to a better place, a new life.
Ba, Olorumbo, Ayireada, Ike.
Olorumbo! Olorumbo! If you want me to vouch, you want on Babisa!
He wants his freedom.
Some of them are starving themselves too, Captain.
This is valuable cargo, Mr. Davy. I can't have slaves killing themselves. Doctor?
This one is gravely ill. Her son? I don't know.
What is it?
The flux, Captain. There's nothing to be done.
Your great-grandfather was on that ship, Samuel. A boy struggling to hold onto hope. His survival tied to the fate of Captain Newton.
Whoa. I'll leave you here, Garrett.
McGee, you take care.
Look out for Plimpton. Samuel. Godspeed, y'all.
There it is.
Whoa, whoa.
You unhitch the horses, Samuel.
Who's inside?
It's a Quaker house. You see that lamp? It's safe. This is where we'll hide you tonight. Here you go.
Come on.
This way, Jim.
Yes, watchman.
What is left of the night?
Morning is coming, but also the night.
Come in, Mr. Garrett.
Thank you, kindly.
We've been expecting you.
Come on in. Here you go.
This here's Samuel Woodward and his family. William Giddens.
Come in. You must be hungry.
There are too many of us.
These men are from Missouri. Harriet Tubman brought them across yesterday.
We cannot all hide here. There's not enough space. Harriet told us that 4 more free black men were kidnapped yesterday.
Now stay calm.
There you are.
Where are you from?
The Monroe place. The biggest plantation in the Norfolk area.
We ran with Mr. Garrett's help.
And Dodd's.
Chair don't build itself.
The boys at the roadblock were right.
Willie!
You're next.
Willie!
Giddens! Giddens is the first safe house!
Think that Quaker's still running the safe house?
He's a bigger fool than the Monroe boy here.
Fool? You're run out of time! You told Monroe Sunday!
I want no more killing! You hear me?
You clean yourself up.
We've got a long ride ahead of us.
Visitors. Mr. Plimpton, I believe.
Samuel?
Is there a gun, Mr. Giddens?
There will be no shooting in this
house. They're not taking us back there.
Mess up. Come on, y'all, out the back. Hitch up the horses to the wagon. Let's go.
There's no time, Samuel. You need to hide.
Quickly! There are too many of us.
We'll be around here somewhere.
Come on. Come on.
Jim, stay by me.
Quick, Kira. Let's go. Come on.
Decide to go around the back.
What can I do for you, mister?
Where's Garrett? Help famous conductor of the Underground Railroad.
You should board the train too, sir. One day we'll all stand at the terminal before God.
I don't believe in God, Mr. Giddens. I got nothing to say to him.
Never play poker, Mr. Giddens. This isn't them. Where are they? The others.
Others?
The ones I came for. Garrett and his passengers from Norfolk. Where are they?
I have nothing to say to you.
Search the rest of the house and the barn and find Willie. Hang for the Skiddens.
We mustn't be afraid of death, Mr. Plimpton.
Plimpton! Outside!
Samuel! Down!
Get up! Get up! Come on! Ah.
Yeah.
Shoot him!
Alive, I said. Great help you were. Go hitch their horses to the wagon. And get those slaves tied up now!
I'm afraid those gentlemen have gone, Mr. Plinton. Out the back door. You have lost them all. Dear, dear.
You have broken a federal law, Mr. Giddens.
Slaves are gone, boss.
The Fugitive Slave Act requires that you assist in the recapture of escaping slaves. That is the law, sir.
I follow my conscience, Mr. Plimpton, whatever the consequences. We're just God-fearing folk here, that's all.
God-fearing folk is my biggest problem.
Phillips is waiting for us on the platform. Quick now, while the train pulls in. Main line at Woodbridge. That's where you need to get off. Then make your way to Pikesville.
You ain't coming with us?
No. My job was to get you on the train. Right, and my job is done.
Next one, come on.
You'll be looked after every step of the way. Your first taste of freedom, Samuel.
This your compass.
You're made for it. Godspeed.
Right, oh, if I got my ticket, Lord, can I ride?
Get all those over there, too.
Oh, if I got my ticket, Lord, can I ride? Whoa, if I got my ticket, Lord, can I ride?
Push! Move it!
Ride away to heaven on the morning train. If I got my ticket, Lord, if I got my ticket,
can I ride?
Lord, if I got my ticket,
can I ride?
Ride away to heaven in the morning. I hear them talk about the gospel train. I wanna get on it, yeah, that's my aim. Stand at the station and patiently wait. The train is coming and it's never late. So long coming that it worried my mind.
Stop that train!
I thought it was late,
it!
But it was just
Stop!
In time. Lord, if I got my ticket. Lord, if I got my ticket. Lord, if I got my ticket. Ride away to heaven in the morning.
Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. A long ways from home, a long ways, a long ways from home. Sometimes I feel like I'm almost gone. Sometimes I feel like I can't go on. Sometimes I feel like I'm almost gone. way up to my heavenly land. Way up to my heavenly land. But I'm a true believer. I'm a true believer. A long ways from home.
Take any food.
Come now, you're feeble, you must eat.
Freedom for all is the hope of love and forgiveness. Stand and face this truth, and your heart will find its voice.
Come on. There's no time to lose. Come on. Let's go. Come on, Liz. I got you.
Looking for Miss Davenport, sir. Thank you.
Expecting you. Come on.
I am compelled to request you, as a gentleman, to shun studiously the society of Lady Gay Spanker.
Good gracious! Wherefore and by what right do you make such a demand?
Why, I am a distant relative of the Spankers.
Damn, sir, if you don't appear to be related to every family in Great Britain!
Mr. Woodward, good evening. We were expecting you this morning.
Mrs. Davenport, we've been on foot, and our grandmother Adair has been ill.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Please, come and make yourself as comfortable as possible. And Rose.
We need some rest.
No, Rose, sustenance.
Please, sit down. Sit.
We didn't hear from Garrett, and we're worried.
We got away on a train.
Is someone following you?
Yes, sir. A man by the name of Plimpton.
Plimpton? He's back? Oh, fiddlesticks. Well, don't mind me, dears.
My husband, Mr. Barney Fagan.
Esquire.
It's Plan B now, darling.
Yeah.
The graveyard scenario.
Oh, yes, that's always the crowd, please.
You'll have to bunk down with us here tonight.
Yes. There are men watching the hall, and we can't be too careful.
Oh, Barney, as you can see, thinks that men are spying on us.
Well, they are spying on us, dear. I saw them in the alleyway.
But he's always been a paranoid performer. Ah. The critics will loathe me.
My dear, we are slaves to the critics. I promise you, we will get you across the line before tomorrow night, Saturday at the latest. Tomorrow and tomorrow and tomorrow, creep in its petty pace from day to day to the last syllable of recorded time, and all our yesterdays have lighted fools the way to dust to death.
We'll do the best we can.
Yes, and we have assembled a cast of supernumeraries just for the occasion. That ate him.
Barney, we have got to rehearse for tomorrow. What do you think about this?
Yes, true. Brilliant.
Gather round, everyone. We must learn this little ditty.
Pass me not, O gentle Savior.
Hear my humble
cry. Are you sure this is my key?
Absolutely.
While on others thou art.
Do not pass me by.
Do not pass me by.
So
dance tonight, my dear.
Oh, really? I wasn't sure about the key. Drew never seems to get it right. I thought I was a little flat.
No, 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 no. Drew was a little sharp. We must pray for strength and steel ourselves for tomorrow. Our charges are terrified, and rightly so. Vigilance, my darling girl. For our sake as well as theirs.
Yes, there we go. Nice fit. Now, sit. Yes, sit, sit. Mm-hmm. Oh, no, look straight ahead. Oh, yes. Marvelous.
This ain't never gonna work, Mr. Barney.
He's right, Mr. Barney.
Fanny, are you absolutely sure?
Absolutely. Now, Jim, this is it.
Don't you worry. Everything will be just perfect.
Esquire.
Clinton's the name. I'm looking for some escaped slaves.
Slaves? Oh, God forbid. I don't believe I've even seen a slave. Have I, dear?
You ever seen this man? Thomas Garrett.
No. But what a marvelous face. Allow me, with modest regards, Barney Fagan Esquire.
Now, y'all know that you can go to jail for aiding and abetting the runaway.
Right? Yeah, well, you have my permission to search our, well, what some would refer to as our theater.
How good an actor are you?
Oh, exemplary, sir.
There's no way I would know if you were lying.
You must excuse me, sir. One of our troupe has played his last performance. It is a cruel, cruel world.
Perambulator is yours.
Wagon? He means you can keep the wagon.
Yes, one of the best ensemble pieces ever.
Two, three.
Nearly, my dear.
Reverend Frederick Douglass will meet you at his church in Elmira. Here are your instructions.
Thank you, Mrs. Davenport.
Here, Vanessa. I wore it as Portia. It's yours.
Keep it hidden, my dear. Now, you'd better hurry. There's quite a tempest brewing, and we have to bury our dead.
Thank you, sir.
Reverend Douglass will see you through.
Get up. Come on.
Captain! Timbers on the port side!
Release the slaves, Davy, else they all drown.
If this will not do it, Lord, have mercy on us.
Freedom for all is the hope of love and forgiveness.
Stand and face this truth, and your heart will find its voice.
Don't inflict your wrath on these men when I'm the one who doubted!
Captain Newton was reborn that night, even as the storm raged and shattered the world he once knew.
Yes, we did, Azaz.
God protected us.
Yes. Yes, he did. I remember our time together. Day after day, working for that monster. Starved and shackled. I lost all hope. But not you. You live with strength and determination. I owe you my life, Azaz. How can I repay you?
I am a man. Am I not your brother?
Yes. Yes, Azaz. My brother.
Be saved.
No, no, hang on. No. Drink.
But I want you to have these. The Bible belonged to your great-grandfather, a gift from Mr. Newton himself. Read the Bible. How sweet the sound. You are not alone.
Yeah.
is no God for us.
Samuel, no.
Into Canada there over the Niagara River.
Free?
Over my dead body, Clem.
They'll be meeting up with Douglas at his church in town.
Why'd you quit?
I heard you caught a free black man and killed him by mistake.
Whatever you say, Willie.
I think all colored should be slaves. Or dead. Any man who thinks otherwise is a damn fool.
It's just a great big game for you and the boy.
Conscience got the better of you.
That's it, old man. There's the Plimpton from the stories, not the slave sympathizer who's running this hunt like he's a railroad conductor.
Willie!
Enough, Willie. You'll keep, old man. I'm riding to town. Do what we came here for.
Please, Samuel. We're so close. Have faith. Mr. Douglas will help us.
Help us what? Run some more? No, they're gonna run us down, Nessa. They're gonna beat us again. They're gonna put the collar to us again. Adira said, have faith. Faith. Look what good that did her. No. No. Death saved her from where we're going.
Oh, Sammy, stop. Please stop. Not here. Not now.
Why? Why God chose us to be half human? To be strung up whenever they want? Huh? To work all our lives and to die? No. This church, this church, this church means nothing! This church means nothing to us! It ain't done nothing for us!
We have Jim.
I don't want you to know.
You should hold on for Jim. And hold on for me. Hold on to me. Hold on to God. Not a second, or another minute, not an hour, or another day. But at this moment, with my arms outstretched, you to make a way as you have done so many times before, through a window or an open door. I stretch my hands to thee. Rescue me. I need you right away.
Vanessa.
Mr. Douglas. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm dead to him, sir. Ed.
He needs you more than ever now. He needs all your strength.
Ma, I saw Pa. He's outside, and he's so...
I'll go to him. Stay here.
Clinton won't like this, Willie.
It's been 2 weeks. Clinton's been letting a bunch of dogs get the better of him.
Son.
Let's get him.
So you you're telling me you rode off and you left the others there?
We got Samuel.
That's what you're telling me. They could be halfway to the state line by now. What good is he without her? And what use is Douglas? Huh? Samuel, you're causing me one hell of a headache. You know that? Unfortunately, I need all of yous. Something that Monroe's watchdog here don't seem to understand.
Yeah, but we got him.
Drop it!
All right.
Look, you hold all the cards in this hand. Look, there he goes. You too! Drop it!
Are you on time?
You're gonna be running your whole life, you know that, don't you? You better shoot me now, because we're gonna hunt you down like dogs.
Samuel, you will never be free.
Come on!
Remember what I said, Samuel. Don't move!
You must go quickly. There's not much time.
Find him, Buster.
Yes, sir. I just left Mr. Barton. He sends his regards and congratulations.
Congratulations.
A successful maiden voyage, sir. Only 24 dead.
Yes, sir. And 16 with the flux. God knows how long they will live. Congratulations.
I want that one and that one.
Excellent choice, Charisma.
Thank you, Father.
C-137 and 38.
And thank you, Father.
Thank you.
Back 149.
You must go with them now. Take this. It's a gift.
We sail on the tide, Mr. Davy.
Up on the block now, we have slave number 149. Male, age 11 years old, no signs of flux. Let's sell him. Let me hear $20.
Do thee love her? Comfort her. Honor and keep her, in sickness and in health. So long as you both shall live.
I do.
You all know me. But I'm not the same man who left Rochester 10 months ago. That John Newton was dramatically changed one night in a storm on the Atlantic Ocean. In utter despair, I cried out and was given another chance. Take away a toy from a child
and give him another. And he is satisfied. But if he be hungry, no toy will do. Thus, as newborn babes, true believers desire the sincere milk of the word. And the desire of grace in this way is grace. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see.
Look, Pa! I can see the crossing!
I'll wait here.
Come on, boy. Let's go. We're free, son.
Free!
Got you, boy.
Ah! Hey, boy! Come on back now, boy.
Yes?
Don't make me do something stupid. Come on! Willie! Clem, are you with me?
We'll split Monroe's money.
They're mine. No more killing, I mean it.
Monroe told me dead or alive, old man.
Clem, you just gonna stand there? You best get out of here, Clem. I ain't gonna ask again. So you're just gonna shoot Monroe's daughter, huh? I'm all yours, Mr. Plimpton!
Shut your mouth, slave boy! No deals!
Just tell me what to do, Mr. Plimpton!
Shut your mouth, nigger! Never!
Samuel?
Mr. Plimpton.
Enough. No more killing. Monroe, give me this to bring you in. Take it. Make a life for her. And your son. A little gift from his grandfather. Huh? You're free now, Samuel.
a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I.
Pilgrim of sorrow, I'm tossed in this wide world alone. No hope have I for tomorrow, so I've started to make heaven my. Sometimes I'm tossed and driven, Lord. Sometimes I don't know where to roam, but I have heard of a city. And I've started to make it my home. My mother is already in glory, but my father's still walking in sin. My brothers and sisters won't own me because I am trying to get in.
Mm-hmm.